Hello, good day everyone. It is a pleasure to have you join our online worship service today. The elders of BICF warmly welcome each one of you. Let's focus on worshiping the Lord at this moment. May we all feel His presence as we praise and worship Him. The theme of today's sermon is Leaders are Messengers of God. Our speaker today is Miss Marijke Bangun. Before we go on, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we gather today in your presence with hearts full of gratitude and praise. We thank you for the opportunity to worship you as we enter this time of worship. We ask your Holy Spirit to be with us, guide us, and speak to us. Lord, prepare our hearts and mind to receive your word. Please help us to set any distraction or worries so we can fully focus on you. May our songs, prayers, and reflection please you and bring us closer to knowing your love and grace. Bless Ms. Marijke Bangun, who will speak your words and deliver your message with clarity and convictions. We pray for those who could not be with us today, that they too may feel your presence and peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us now sing a praise song titled Your Words Are Wonderful, led by Rosa, and then we will listen to the sermon.
Your ways are wonderful, unfolding like the dawn. Oh, wellspring and the rock we rest upon. We trust your promises that keep our hope alive. They steady us throughout life's weary climb. Oh,
Then Jesus went around teaching from village to village. Calling the 12 to him, he began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over impure spirits. These were his instructions. Take nothing for the journey except a staff, no bread, no bag, no money in your belts. Wear sandals, but not an extra shirt. Whenever you enter a house, stay there until you leave that town. And if any place will not welcome you or listen to you, leave that place and shake the dust off your feet as a testimony against them. They went out and preached that people should repent. They drove out many demons and anointed many sick people with oil and healed them. King Herod heard about this. Jesus' name had become well known. Some were saying, John the Baptist has been raised from the dead, and that is why miraculous powers are at work in him. Others said, he is Elijah. And still others claimed, he is a prophet, like one of the prophets of long ago. But when Herod heard this, he said, John, whom I beheaded, has been raised from the dead. For Herod himself had given orders to have John arrested, and he had him bound and put in prison. He did this because of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, whom he had married. For John had been saying to Herod, it is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife. So Herodias nursed a grudge against John and wanted to kill him, but she was not able to because Herod feared John and protected him, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man. When Herod heard John, he was greatly puzzled, yet he liked to listen to him. Finally, the opportune time came. On his birthday, Herod gave a banquet for his high officials and military commanders and the leading men of Galilee. When the daughter of Herodias came in and danced, she pleased Herod and his dinner guests. The king said to the girl, ask me for anything you want, and I'll give it to you. And he promised her with an oath, whatever you ask, I will give you, up to half my kingdom. She went out and said to her mother, what shall I ask for? The head of John the Baptist, she answered. At once the girl hurried into the king with the request. I want you to give me right now the head of John the Baptist on a platter. The king was greatly distressed. But because of his oaths and his dinner guests, he did not want to refuse her. So he immediately sent an executioner with orders to bring John's head. The man went, beheaded John in the prison, and brought back his head on a platter. He presented it to the girl, and she gave it to her mother. On hearing of this, John's disciples came and took his body and laid it in a tomb.
Beloved BICF family, greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The theme of the sermon today is leaders are messengers of God. There are at least two roles of God's messenger in the Old Testament: to deliver a message from God to God's people, and to deliver a message on behalf of the people to God. The first can be categorized as a prophet and the second as a priest. A prophet warns those in power on behalf of the people, especially the poor, the oppressed, the marginalized. A priest, on the other hand, intercedes to God, bringing petitions and supplications on behalf of the people, especially those who are under oppression. And today's sermon will focus on the prophetic role of a leader. If we read the previous pericope of our Bible passage today, we learn that Jesus had sent his disciples to proclaim repentance that would bring salvation healing to many people. The disciples cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. Because of these miracles, the name of Jesus became widely known, and people were asking, who is this Jesus? Some were saying he is the risen John the Baptist, some believed he was Elijah, and others concluded that Jesus was a prophet of the past. From here we can see that the ministry of Jesus is a ministry of liberation from oppression. Therefore, people associate Jesus with prophets. Upon hearing about Jesus, King Herod believes that Jesus is John the Baptist. I will quote verse 16. It states, "But when Herod heard of it, he said, 'John, whom I beheaded, has been raised.'" So who is John the Baptist? The Gospel of Mark introduces John as a fulfillment of a prophecy from the book of Isaiah about a messenger being sent ahead and a voice crying out in the wilderness. John is an ascetic prophet who wears clothes of camel's hair and lives by eating locusts and wild honey. John's message is the proclamation of baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sin. He also proclaims that someone will come after him who will not baptize with water but with the Holy Spirit. John prepares the way for the coming of Jesus to bring healing, love, and liberation. John was doing a ministry of prophetic leadership in his time. Interestingly, in the same passage, we can see another form of leadership projected by King Herod. He is an arrogant, manipulative, and oppressive leader. He took his brother's wife to be his wife, which was then publicly criticized by John the Baptist. His wife, Herodias, who was a former wife of his brother, wanted to kill John because she was angry. But Herod protected him by putting John in the prison. And one day, King Herod held a birthday banquet and invited three groups of people: high officials, military commanders, and the leading men of Galilee. In this party, he displayed his daughter's dance to amuse and please his eyes and the eyes of his guests. Charmed by the performance of his daughter, Herod offers her an extravagant gift in front of his prominent guests. By doing this, he is showing how powerful he is. Impulsively, he promises to even give half of his kingdom to his daughter. Herod's wife takes this opportunity to revenge by suggesting her daughter to ask for John's head on a platter, as if it's the final course for the grand meal. Herod, as a leader, has to protect his honor and reputation in front of his prominent male-dominated guests. What is at stake is no longer protecting life, but protecting his own image at the cost of another's life. Beloved family in Christ, I would like to draw three important lessons from this passage in regards to our theme today. First, we are called to be leaders in many ways at many levels. In this first point, I want to emphasize that we are called to first of all be a leader to ourselves. This means that we have to take care of our body, mind, heart, and spirit. I would like to share a testimony. Recently, I was diagnosed with endometrial cancer, and in January had a complete hysterectomy, and in May completed the radiation therapy. I thank God for this healing journey because it was early detected, and God's provision was evident through so many people around me who supported me in so many ways. But I also learned something. Before this diagnosis, I practiced a healthier way of life by stopping almost 90% of processed food and consistently doing resistance training. I also spent a good amount of time learning things related to health. This was, of course, triggered by COVID-19. Little did I know, these 2 years of gradual change in diet, way of life, and educating myself about health is a preparation for my body and mind to be strong and agile in facing cancer and enduring the recovering post-operation and radiation therapy. I learned the importance of acceptance and pray for adaptability. From here, I want to suggest that we are leader of ourselves, and it is a continuous process. There should be a conscious decision of how we take care of our life and how we make decisions in life. Jesus said that we have to love our neighbor as ourselves. We cannot love and care for others if we don't first of all do it to ourselves. First, we are leader of our own lives. Second, we are called into the ministry of prophetic leadership. Leadership is a ministry. It is an opportunity to serve others with the power in our hands. And based on our Bible passage, the nature of leadership that we are digging in is prophetic. It is prophetic in nature. It is in line with the ministry of prophets in the past and Jesus himself. Jesus became well known and people associated him with prophets, such as Elijah and other prophets, because of the nature of his ministry. His ministry gives birth to healing and liberation to the people. We see a list of manifestation of healing and liberation in the book of Mark. At least I have listed here. Healing and liberation happened to a man with an unclean spirit, Peter's mother-in-law, a leper, a paralytic, a man with a withered hand, a woman with a hemorrhage, Jairus' daughter, a deaf and mute man, a blind man at Bethsaida, and blind Bartimaeus. These are the list of human beings who experienced the power of healing and liberation from the prophetic ministry of Jesus. As Christians, we are also invited into the ministry of prophetic leadership. As parents, as workers in the marketplaces, as members of government institutions, as members of the wider society, as deacons or elders in the church, you can add more positions. We are all invited into this ministry of prophetic leadership. Our actions as followers of Jesus Christ should be the embodiment of God's healing and liberation. We can ask simple questions to ourselves. What have I done with the power and position given to me by God to liberate others from poverty, illness, rejections, and sins? We are not called to be police or judge, but have we contributed something to the shalom or welfare of the people around us? Prophet Jeremiah reminded the people to seek the welfare of the city where God has sent them and to pray to the Lord on its behalf. Thirdly, we need to be conscious of the power configuration that we have as leader. Be careful because we are vulnerable to abusing power and also vulnerable to manipulation. We are in charge of every decision that we make. The wife of Herod, Herodias, is always interpreted as the culprit in the death of John the Baptist. But we know that King Herod chose to murder John to save his honor and reputation in front of his prominent male-dominated guests. In this plot, he cannot wash his hands from the murder. And yes, Herodias took advantage of this situation. Her hunger for revenge and her ability to read the situation enabled her to manipulate King Herod through her daughter. This incident highlights the dangerous interplay of power, manipulation, and impulsive patriarchal arrogancy within Herod's court. Not only was John the Baptist sacrificed, but the daughter, their daughter, is also a victim of power abuse. Beloved family in Christ, leaders are messengers of God. Yes, it's true, but be careful. We are vulnerable to any abuse of power. We may not have strong power like King Herod, but in some ways we do have power in our hands. It can be dangerous when we exercise it on behalf of our pride, honor, and reputation. A ministry of prophetic leadership will never side on the interests of the power. Elijah the prophet warned King Ahab for the murder of Naboth because he wanted to occupy his vineyard. Nathan the prophet warned King David for the murder of Uriah because he wanted to cover his sexual misconduct that caused Bathsheba to be pregnant. And John the Baptist warned King Herod for taking his brother's wife. We can see that God's heart is always for the weak. Jeremiah 20:22, verse 3 says, "Do justice and righteousness and deliver from the hand of the oppressor him who has been robbed, and do no wrong or violence to the resident alien, the fatherless and the widow, nor shed innocent blood in this place." God's preference option is always for the poor, the oppressed, marginalized, and excluded. And we are called, we are invited into this ministry. We are not prophet, but we have to proclaim prophetic voices for justice. Beloved family in Christ, we are called to be leaders of ourselves. We are called into the ministry of prophetic leadership. And I pray that we will use the power in our hands to bring healing and liberation like Jesus Christ and other prophets have done. May the Holy Spirit continue to bring conviction and courage to walk into the ministry of prophetic leadership. Amen.
We have heard the sermon, the Word of God. May the sermon bless us as we continue to follow Jesus as our Savior and Lord. Brothers and sisters, let's give our offering to God. Our offerings are an act of worship. The Word of God in 1 Chronicles 29:14 says, King David said, "But who am I and what is my people that we should be able thus to offer willingly? For all things come from you, and of your own have we given you." Brothers and sisters, let's give with a heart full of gratitude as an act of worship. You may give your offering through BICF, and may God bless you. Now let us pray, a family prayer led by Elder Suharno.
Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you with hearts full of gratitude and praise. Thank you for the opportunity to gather virtually as a community, united in our faith and love for you. We begin with thanksgiving, acknowledging all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. Thank you for your constant presence, your unending love, and your abundant grace. We are grateful for this community and for the ways you are working in and through us. We lift up Boko International Christian Fellowship, BICF, to you. We pray for the continuation and growth of this fellowship. May it be an entity of your love and truth, drawing more people into a deeper relationship with you. Bless all the programs and initiatives of BICF, that it may bear much fruit and bring glory to your name. We pray for the well-being of us all, physically as well as spiritually. Surround us, O Lord, with your protection and fill our hearts with your peace and joy. We especially lift up our children who are schooling, asking that you grant them wisdom, understanding, and a love for learning. Guide them in their studies and help them to grow in character and faith. We lift up our brothers and sisters who are struggling with sickness. Touch them with your healing hand and restore them to full health. Grant them comfort and strength during this time. We pray for us in our daily jobs. Bless our works and provide us with opportunities to thrive and make a positive impact. Give us strength and perseverance in our daily tasks. We lift up the Masia family, Masia, Manas, and Hannah. Bless them abundantly, protect them, and guide them in all their endeavors. May they feel your presence and love in their lives. Let the internal hope of peace be with them so that they overcome the challenges of this time. We pray for our country. Bless our leaders with wisdom and integrity as they make decisions that affect the lives of many. We ask for your presence in our country. We ask for your peace and prosperity to reign in our land. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We are about to end this service. Let's sing I, the Lord of Sea and Sky, led by Janice.
Speak my
Brothers and sisters, thank you for joining us. We hope you join us next week, and happy Sunday, and may God bless you.
The Lord lift his countenance upon